What's going on? It's your boy Jay coming at you with a Splatter Talk Cinema review. Kinda noticed that the reviews that we're doing before were more of a retrospective look on the movies that we chose. So I decided to hit you guys with a more traditional spoiler-free review, but also give you guys the retrospective stuff as well in future videos. With that being said, let's get into it. The film I'm going to be reviewing today is the remake to the classic Stephen King novel, turn movie, turn remake, and we don't count The Rage, Carrie 2, because that movie sucked balls. Directed by Kimberly Pierce and starring Hit Girl from Kick-Ass 1 and 2, Chloe Grace Moretz, we follow the events of the outcast Carrie White. In the original film, Carrie is this misfit who the popular teens harass throughout the movie. Her home life wasn't any better because her mother was fucking crazy and super overprotective. In the movie, we learn Carrie has telepathic abilities, and after a devastating prank pulled by the jocks of the school at prom, Carrie uses those telepathic powers to take revenge on the bullies who tormented her. With a budget of $30 million, the Carrie remake was released to theaters October 7, 2013 and was able to rack in $85 million at the box office. Released by Sony Pictures, this Carrie movie asked me to think outside the box a little too much. The original was believable because I could see how Sissy Spacek could have been that loner at school. The kid no one liked. She looked the part. It was hard for me to see that in Chloe. She just looked too cool for school. And the fact she played such a kick-ass character, no pun intended, in Kick-Ass 1 and 2, I just couldn't wrap my head around people bullying her in the way that they did in the movie. I caught myself yelling at the TV talking about, "Blow their fucking head off, Hit Girl!" Well, no matter if you're Hit Girl or not, everyone has to deal with bullies, I guess. The acting was okay. I had no problems with how the characters were portrayed, even though the two main bullies were over-the-top, typical Stephen King bullies, which I can't stand. Almost every movie that's an adaptation of a Stephen King novel, the bullies are psychopathic assholes. Anyway, Chloe portrayed Carrie well enough, it's just I couldn't suspend my belief enough to see her as an outcast. Every time Julianne Moore was on the scene was a delight though. Every scene where there were holy shit moments when she was on it. Nobody else really stood out to me because I honestly couldn't give a shit about them. Maybe it's because I came into this movie with the last act in mind. I just kept thinking, get to the fucking killing, damn it. The movie does drag along in spots. I caught myself getting on Facebook the first time I tried to rewatch it. It just didn't keep my attention the way the original did. It took a couple of start and stops and rewinds for me to get through it. With a runtime of 99 minutes, the remake of Carrie was one of those movies where you just asked yourself, did we really need this? The last act was very entertaining, but was it entertaining enough to sit through 40 minutes of bullshit? Not really. Then, to see her pulling some next-level X-Men mutant-type shit at the end of the movie was like, okay, now I'm fucking done. I just can't anymore. I can't. I'll give the 2013 remake of Carrie a C-. The only reason I don't give this movie a D is because the final act. The movie had that Nightmare on Elm Street 2010 feel to it, which I didn't like. There was too much CGI being used in places that it didn't need to be used. The practical effects from the original seemed better than what I watched more than two decades later. I think Chloe needs to take notes from Scarlet Witch with her hand-wavy shit because it didn't look believable. Plus, her power set was just way out of control. Like, why in the hell did she need to fly off the fucking stage after electrocuting everybody? Spoiler. If you have absolutely nothing to do during this pandemic, go ahead and pop in this movie and give it a look. It'll be 99 minutes that you can't get back, so make sure you want to sacrifice that much time out of your life. If you like what you saw, smash that like button and subscribe to the channel. Let us know what you think about the 2013 Carrie remake. Also, I want to give a huge shout out to Derek from Derek's Horror Corner for having me on his live as we defended A Nightmare on Elm Street 4, The Dream Master. It's a very informative and funny video. We were able to talk about the movies with other guys from different YouTube channels. Shout out CDR Movie Reviews, Christian Hanna, 3B Videos, and Desmond's Flicks. The link to the video as well as their channels will be in the description below. With that being said, I appreciate everyone for watching these videos. I hope everyone is staying safe during this COVID-19 pandemic. Remember to socially distance yourself, wash your hands, and take care. With that being said, this is your boy Jay, Splatter Talk Cinema Review. It's a wrap.